Hello, welcome to another coding challenge. In this coding challenge, I am going to build from scratch in JavaScript a fractal tree. And I'm going to do kind of, you know, you can see once this video is over and I've made one example of it, you can see sort of a variety of images here of things you might be able to make from it. And you'll also see that there are a few different follow-up videos after this one that show other techniques for generating trees in different ways. But let's just get started first by, let me just draw you a diagram to sort of, so that we can kind of understand what's going on. So the core idea of a fractal tree is we have a recursive definition. So what is a recursive definition? A recursive definition is something that's defined in terms of itself. And actually, there's a math function, which is known as factorial. 4 factorial equals 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. You know, 10 factorial equals 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 1. Now, 3 factorial is equal to 3 times 2 times 1. So you could actually say that 4 factorial is equal to 4 times 3 factorial, or that any number n factorial is equal to itself times n minus 1 factorial. And this is a recursive definition. I'm defining factorial in terms of itself, which seems like something you shouldn't be allowed to do, but it is something you are allowed to do. In fact, you're encouraged to do, and all, even though you might sometimes get a headache, all sorts of wonderful, beautiful, elegant things can arise out of recursive definitions, one of which being fractal trees. Okay, back over here. That was completely unnecessary, but I did it anyway. So what is the recursive def? This is like some math stuff and some numbers. What does it mean to have something that's visual defined recursively? Well, we have this idea of a branch. So I'm going to say a branch is a beginning and end point. And it is defined as having two branches attached. You probably can't read that. It doesn't really matter. This says branch is defined as a line that has two branches attached, like this. So let me draw that over here. This is a branch and has two branches attached. Oh, but these are also branches. So they have two branches attached. Oh, and these are all also branches. So they have two branches attached. Oh, and these are all also branches. And they have two branches, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So a branch is defined as something that has two branches, and those have branches. This is known as recursion. Now, one thing you might be thinking about is, where does this end? So in the theoretical, magical world of fantasy, this would go on forever. And these branches are getting shorter and shorter, and they would get infinitely small. But in the world of pixels and programming, we have to stop somehow. So we need an exit condition. And actually, that's built into this up here. I just didn't explicitly state it. Whenever you get to 1, you stop counting down in this multiplication for a factorial. And the same thing is true here. We could say continue branching. Each branch has two branches attached to it until it is less than some number of pixels long. So this is the idea. And the way that this ends up happening in code is if you have a function, whoops, that's not how you spell function. In code, if you write a function and you call it something like branch, a recursive function in code is defined according to itself, meaning somewhere in that function, you're going to actually call itself. So you're calling the function you're defining from within the function, and it results in this sort of loop. I'm going to call branch, which calls branch, which calls branch, which calls branch, and eventually stops at some point. So this is the idea of recursion and how it's implemented in code. Let's go and actually write this code now. Dare I say, I'm a little bit afraid to do this, but let's see what happens. Okay, so so what I have here is a P5JS sketch. P5JS is a JavaScript framework. Links in the video description of where you can get it and get started with it. And the only thing that's going on right now is that a HTML5 canvas has been created, and I'm drawing a gray background there. So I just want you to be able to see that. I'm going to go back to over here where I'm running it, and you can see, whoop. You can see there's my 400 by 400 pixel background. So I want to have the trunk of the tree to start with. So just to kind of get that going, let's draw a line that goes from the center, 200, and the bottom to the center and the bottom minus some length. So I'm going to make a length variable which starts at 100. And now, and this line, I want it to be white. And so now if I run this again, you can see, okay, I've got a line at the bottom. So I have the trunk. So what I want to do now is actually put that code that's drawing the trunk into a function. So I want to call branch, and branch is actually going to draw that line. So let's do that. So the next thing I'm going to do is make this a function. And one thing I want to do with this function is I want to give this function an argument, and that argument is how long to draw that branch. So I'm actually going to put that variable here in the function, and then I'm going to say line 200 height, 200 height minus length. So whoops. So now here, I actually want to, and I'll just say stroke 255 here. Now what I want to do is say branch, I forgot what I was doing, 100. So you can see here that the idea here, same result, is that now I'm calling this function branch, and I'm giving it the value 100. Now, here's the thing. The way that this is going to work is I don't actually want to, let me come over here. So I want to do is actually instead of drawing the tree starting at this bottom location, which is 200 comma height, I want to move the origin, which is here, all the way down to here. I always want to be drawing the branches relative to the origin by using the translate p5 function, which sort of moves that 0, 0 point around. And once we start doing a little bit more of this, you'll see why that makes a lot of sense. So let me come back over to the code. And what I'm going to do is right here, I'm going to say translate to 200 comma height, branch 100. And now this becomes draw line from 0, 0 to 0 comma negative length. So now if I run this program, same exact result. So we have a very simple beginning. We are translating to the bottom. We are drawing a branch from the bottom straight up. So what do I want to do next? I have drawn a branch from the bottom straight up. Well, guess what I want to do? I want to rotate and draw a branch to the right. So what I want to do is now say, let me rotate by, like, I don't know, 45 degrees. Let's start with 45 degrees is pi divided by 4. And then let me draw another branch, 0, 0, 0, negative length. Oh, you know what? I also need to translate. Ah, so before I'm down here and I drew the branch like this, and now I want to start drawing from here. So after I finish drawing the branch, I need to translate back up to here. Okay, so before I rotate, now I need to translate up 0, comma, negative length. So we're drawing that bottom line, we're translating up to the top, we're rotating and drawing another line. Let's see what that looks like. There we go. Second branch. Now, I want that second branch to be a little bit shorter. So maybe I'll make it 2/3 of its size. So multiply it by 0.67. So you can see now it's a little bit shorter. But have I done anything recursive here yet? So am I really going to go and draw every single line of the tree as a separate line function? No. What do I actually want to do? I just want to call branch again. And what do I want to call branch? With a slightly shorter branch. Now, I'm tempted to run this, and I could run this, but if I run this, my browser's gonna crash most likely. Let's just try it. Danger, danger. Let's live dangerously. I'm gonna run this. So you can see, good, we got an error. Maximum call stack size exceeded. So what happened here? You can see it started doing it, but it just like decided it couldn't do it anymore. What happened? It's calling branch from within branch, and that's an infinite loop. Branch calls branch calls branch calls branch calls branch. So I need to say at some point, don't call branch anymore. Well, every time I call branch, length is shrinking. So I could actually just say something like, only if length is greater than like 4 pixels, should I actually bother calling branch again. So now, you can see here, I'm drawing the first line, and then I'm calling branch again and rotating, calling branch again and rotating. So, and we could see here, I could make that angle of rotation a variable. So I said it was pi divided by 4, and I could rotate by, I'm going to call that angle actually, by an angle. And one thing I could do, just so you see, is I can make a slider. Let's just do this really quickly. there is a P5. In the P5 DOM library, I can make things like a slider. And I want to have a slider from 0 to 2 pi. Oops, I can't spell. How do you spell 2 pi? And I want it to start at maybe pi divided by 4. And then what I want to do is say in draw, angle equals slider dot value. So what I'm doing now is if I run this, create slider is not defined, probably because I need to actually reference the DOM library in the index file. So now you can see, look at this. So one thing, by the way, it's working, but notice how the slider, it can only move up by units of 1. So one thing that I forgot is there's an argument. There's a fourth argument, which is the step size for the slider. So I want to move it up by like lower increments. And you can see here, now I can sort of play with that angle, and I can turn what that angle of rotation is for this tree thing. But I've only branched to the right. Now, there's a couple issues. One is this, why do I have this pi is not defined error on sketch line 1? You know what's sort of strange is, is that actually, this is sort of a little weird thing, but pi is a built-in variable, part of the P5 DOM library, the P5 library, not the DOM library. And the P5 library, none of its stuff is available in setup just yet. But it doesn't really matter because I'm getting it from the slider. So let's change that to 0. So I can go back and we can see, okay, so now I have this tree that I can change the angle with this slider. And you can see all the way from 0 to 2 pi. And I probably actually just want to make it from 0 to pi divided by 2 or whatever, but we can change that range later. Now, that's only branching to the right. So what if after I branch to the right, I also then rotate by negative angle and branch to the left? Now, really what I want to do is actually have this if statement around all of that. So the idea here is that for every branch, here's the recursive definition of a branch. Draw a line, and then, as long as it's still long, rotate to the right and draw another line, rotate to the left and draw another line. And do that for every single branch. Let's run this. It's not going to work, and we'll figure out why. Ooh, it did something kind of interesting and crazy. Look at this crazy thing. Now, do you see what's happening? Everything is connected. Everything is connected. It's like this. What did I do? I went like this. Wrong side of this pen. I went like this, and then I branched to the right. And then I branched to the left. And then I branched to the right of that. I don't know what I did, but I'm always going, whatever that recursive order is, I'm always going from where I left off. But actually what I want to do is I want to go to here and branch to the right. And then I need to come back here before I branch to the left. And then this branches to the right, and then come back here before I branch to the left. So the way that I can come back is by using the push and pop functions in P5. Because push is a function that says save the transformation state. So if I move from if I translate from here to there, and then I say push, I save, I can draw this to the right, then I can say pop to restore, and then draw this to the left. So if I come back to the code, you will see that all I need to do is add a push right here before I rotate and branch, and then also, and a pop right after, and also around here. So the idea here is that for every single branch is defined as a line, and then when you get to the end of that line, you save where you are and branch off to the right, restore where you were and branch off to the left. Now, the way the order of things happen is not exactly that, because once you call branch, you're then into the next one, and then you're into the next one, and then you start popping back all the way. I encourage you to try to like do some sort of acted out physical demonstration or drawing, like try to be the computer following all the pushes and pops. But you'll see now if I run this, I believe it will work. And you can see now we have this lovely fractal tree, and I can sort of like change the angle. Now, you know, this is really finished. I've only really scratched the surface here. There's a bunch of things that I might encourage you to think about doing. Number one is, can you keep track of which level of the tree you're on and draw the branch with a different thickness using stroke weight. So that's an interesting problem. I'd be happy to demonstrate a solution at some point to that. You might think about, well, what if the angle isn't the same with all of those branches? What if there is a variable number of branches instead of always two, always with equal angles? And you can see that in this Google image search for fractal tree, you'll see that you can, you know, with various other ways of kind of doing this, you might be able to start to get different types of more chaotic or in some ways organic looking qualities rather than this very exact, perfectly symmetrical fractal. So this concludes this part of just doing this basic fractal tree. I'm going to do this again in the next video, in another video, but instead of using push and pop and translate, I'm actually going to use sine and cosine and some math, and you'll see what doing it that way allows you to do something a little bit different which might interest you based on how you could then modify the tree at a later point. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video, maybe, or maybe not. Goodbye.